Like, I've embedded in my practice the idea of an audit. That way, when it's like, and I've been to an audit, like, it's literally not as scary as people make it out to be, because when you have the documents, it's not a problem. It's only when you're committing fraud, it's only when you're trying to cut corners that you do that. And here's the other food for thought with this audit process. One of the things that you have to assume as you grow your business is that they may audit you. So if you build in the idea that, like, what you've, and you've already done it, that you're gonna make sure that you document everything, you have receipts for everything, that you have reports for everything, that you have it in a nice, neat, form and folder, or, you know, in files, or what have you, like, it's in an organized way, you're not gonna have to really worry about an audit, because, again, you're doing everything correctly. So, as like I said, as a general business practice, definitely keep those records, so that when an audit comes, like, okay, here, like, you know, here are the records, call me when you're done. As opposed to, if you're being fraudulent, then it's, here, let me go over and explain to you. That starts to raise suspicion. That was one of the things that came out of an audit that I've been part of, that if you look like you're disorganized, like, if you're trying to, like, figure stuff out on the fly, then people start to, like, the auditor is going to start to wonder, are you committing fraud? It raises red flags. So your process that you already have in place is already there for you.